legs wake up, it's dinner time.
She could abuse me, beat the dog shit out of me, cheat on me, hit me with her car, and I still mess with her.
Shut your pussy thirsty ass up. God damn. How thirsty you gotta be, bro? Seriously, man. Here's some water. Here's some water. You know, I'll take some water for you, alright? I'll drink some water for you, bro. That's how thirsty you look. I checked this dude's page out, alright? Don't go harass him again. Disclaimer, do not go harass him. I checked his page out. He's just degrading himself in every video. And then on his bio, it said, nothing but jokes. Bro, why are we always joking about masculinity? Why? I don't understand this. You don't see anybody joking about femininity. Toxic femininity? No, not at all, no. They instead are being empowered to be a badass, right? Which brings me to my point, actually. I'm going to actually talk more about this on another video, but I want to briefly mention this. There's a Netflix show called The Rookie, and I watched a couple episodes here and there. And pretty much shows that the premise of that show is a police department in LA, LAPD police department, and they're just showing their everyday lifestyle, their job, what kind of risky job they do, etc., etc. That's what this show is about. And the captain of the whole department is a woman. They're portraying the most badass police officers to be women in there. There's a woman in there who's a detective who's talking crap, who's literally talking down on a federal agent. That's what they're showing in that movie, and the federal agent is not doing anything about it. Ladies, I'm here to tell you, just for your own safety, so that you don't lose your life when you go out there and try to act like these women, is that that is not reality. You are not a big, bold badass just because you have a badge and a gun. And female cops, who are, if you watch me, you know it's true. If a crook, if a bad guy looks at you and sees that you're a woman cop, you're the first target. So acting all big, bold, and all this and that, it's not going to save your life. And they're showing on this movie that these women, these female police officers are beating these bad guys' ass, like on fist fights. Yeah, only in a television show. That's only going to be believable on a TV show and Netflix. If you try to do that as a woman, try to go kick some dude's ass just because you saw some chick do that on TV, you're either going to die or get seriously injured if you walk up to the wrong guy, if you start messing with the wrong guy. Nobody wants to talk about that, right? Nobody, what I just said, nobody will ever mention that in any page besides the small manosphere, quote unquote, that we like to call this space, right? Where we really show you what the truth is. Hey, it's your safety, ladies. If you want to gamble with your life, go ahead and do what you want. Don't come at me and say, I didn't warn you that you just lost your life. Nobody's going to talk about it, but everybody out here talks about, oh, look how big of a simp this guy is. Look how he's wanting to get treated like trash by this girl, but still wanting to mess with her. This guy has a huge following. So what are, and most of his followers are men. So when another man, Generation Z, current generation of young men, are watching somebody who's quote unquote famous, and you don't have to be that famous nowadays. You don't have to have any kind of talent. You just need a cell phone and some kind of a message or something stupid to do to get fame nowadays on social media. So when you have that many young men watching you, what are they thinking? They think that this is normal. They think that they should let a woman walk all over them and they should still accept them after this woman have treated them like crap. Because this is the type of message, these are the type of profiles, accounts that get pushed by social media. My channel doesn't. Shit, most of you guys don't even subscribe to my channel who agree with me, let alone the media who completely disagree with me is going to push me. You guys don't even push my channel who watch me here for free. But nonetheless, man, that if that's what you're seeing day in and day out, because, you know, current generation, Generation Z, and the generation after that, Generation Alpha, they're all over Instagram and TikTok. And they're seeing men being emasculated like this. So that's what they think is the new norm is. That's what they think what normal is. So it's up to you, man. However you want to live your life, okay? I can't go to sleep peacefully at night knowing that I let a woman treat me this poorly and I still stuck around with her. I can't even go to bed at night knowing that a man treated me like this, let alone a bitch. I don't give a shit how quote unquote hot she looks, pretty she looks. Dude, you have no idea how many bad bitches are out here who are 100 times better looking than you without all that clown paint that you got going on your face, girl, that you call makeup. You have no idea how many baddies are on this planet. The only reason why dudes are thirsting over you like this is because these dudes don't know any better that how much better is out there. You have a platform to the point where your reach is more. You reach out to more people. More people are seeing you versus more people are not seeing some bad chick from Romania, from Ukraine, from some Eastern European country, or even Western European country, because that chick probably doesn't have as much social media followers as you do. That's why she is non-existent in most guys' eyes. And because of simps like this guy, again, don't go hate on him. He doesn't know any better, probably. I don't know the guy. But because of him, and guys like him, the current dating market is going to keep getting worse and worse. Because women are going to think that they're better than men just because so many men thirst after them. So many men tell them that they're better than men. So when you keep hearing this over and over again, day in and day out, no wonder. Obviously, you're going to sooner or later start believing that, oh yeah, maybe I am better than all men. Because that's all I hear every day, everywhere I go. No coincidence, right, why this is happening? Follow me on Instagram at Zeekpeak, and I'll see you on the next one.